Ties Center, Food Web, Inclusive Science Class, April Tompkins, General Education Science Teacher.
Right now we're learning about food chains and food webs, and the whole class might be expected to be able to identify the different roles of an organism in a food chain. For example, if it's a primary consumer, a secondary consumer, my students on the alternative framework, I would ask them to make sure they can tell me that each food chain should start with a producer and then be able to identify the energy role of the animals in that food chain, like whether it's an herbivore, omnivore, or carnivore. So where do I want to put the producers on the board? Ready?
Ms. Tompkins is standing in front of a whiteboard at the front of the room. She is holding up two pieces of paper that represent producers in the food chain. She sticks them to the bottom of the whiteboard.
At the bottom, okay? So if it starts here, who gets their energy from the producers? Where do you think the wolf would go? Do you think that the wolf eats, like, grass down here?
Yeah, it might eat grass.
You think so?
No.
I don't know. What do you think a wolf's favorite food might be?
Birds.
A bird? Yeah.
Yeah, that's where it goes.
So if it eats a bird, okay, so come up here and show me. If it's going to eat the bird, should we put it down here under the bird or should we put it up here above the bird?
Above.
Above. Okay, good. Come up above the bird.
A student walks up to the front of the board and places an image of a wolf at the top of the whiteboard, signifying its place near the top of the food chain. There are many other animals to the side and below the wolf on the whiteboard.
Can you move him over a little bit? He doesn't like snakes, so I'm going to move him over a little bit away from the snake. There you go. So now we're going to start making some food chains.
A student walks up to the front of the room. He grabs a marker and goes to the whiteboard. He is going to use the marker to draw arrows on the whiteboard, showing relationships between the various parts of the food chain.
You said we're going to start with the grass, right? Let's start with the grass because we got to start at the bottom, okay? And you said that the worm eats the grass. Perfect, okay? And who's going to eat the worm? Very good. And then, awesome. We have our first food chain done. Yep, pick a marker. I'll tell you what we're picking.
Okay. A second student comes to the front of the room. She grabs a marker and goes to the whiteboard. She uses the marker to draw arrows showing relationships between various parts of the food chain.
All right, so.
The wolf would eat the bird, right?
The wolf would eat the bird.
We just have to draw a line.
Which bird do you want to have? Do you want to have him eat this bird?
Yeah.
Or that one? This one? Okay.
This one.
All right, so you're going to draw a line. Now your line has to have an arrow that's pointing to who's eating.
Does it look weird?
No, it doesn't look weird at all.
I just put a little arrow just like that.
So the bird is eating the wolf?
No.
No, the arrow has to point to the eater. So where should your arrowhead go? Gonna point to the one that's eating. Mm-hmm. So it's gonna point. Put the end of the arrow up there. Point to the wolf.
Mm-hmm. Amber, seventh grader.
We said animals could eat other predators and stuff. What I really like about, I did a wolf, and what I do in class is like I draw all down the answers and notes, and see which one I got wrong or which one is right.
Guys, food chains don't have to be long, right?
A third student goes to the front of the room. He grabs a marker and goes to the whiteboard. He is going to use the marker to draw arrows on the whiteboard, showing relationships between the various parts of the food chain.
All
right. Usually, aren't they usually like four, like organisms?
Usually no more than like four or five. All right, well first let's start at the bottom. So the snail is an herbivore. So if it's an herbivore, what does it eat? Does it eat plants or animals if it's an herbivore? Mm-hmm, it eats plants. Okay, so we're gonna start with one of our plants.
Karen Scott, special education teacher.
Inclusion at North Carroll, working with Ties and laying the groundwork to build a shared vision in the school for students that are on the alternate framework as competent learners. And I think that really has made all the difference. The entire school building a shared vision for students as competent learners is really what made the difference here. So that we can have those conversations, we can collaborate, we can have students in the classes who have learning differences and recognize that we're going to play to their strengths and they are going to be learning and they are getting grades, they're earning grades.